It is Monday, so that means it's another episode of Mike's Motivational Monday. Yeah. Man, can you believe this is the next to the last episode? Thank you so much for rocking with your boy up to this point, man. It's been a fun journey, and today we got a really great episode. We're going to talk about how to make yourself stand out. It's going to be a great one. Come on, let's go talk. Before I started working in the position that I have now in corporate America, the job search was really hard for me. I was interviewing left and right with different companies because I wasn't satisfied at the company that I was at. You know, I was ready to move on. And upon starting to looking, I was interviewing for any and everywhere, any and every IT job, and people were turning me down left and right. And so I was like, man, I'm at a loss. And so then I checked the university website that I went to, and they were having a career fair. I applied for some of the companies who were going to be there, and I also sent their recruiter an email. Lo and behold, a recruiter from the current company that I'm at right now emailed me back. He said, hey man, I remember you from the last career fair that we had. Will you be able to make it to this career fair? I emailed him back and told him, no, I won't be able to make it to this career fair, but if you got me an interview, I'll be able to make it to that. A couple of weeks went by, and he emailed me back and said, hey, we got your interview. And so, first thing I had to do once I got the interview was I did my research. Whenever you come into an opportunity that you're unfamiliar with, make sure you do your research. Research is the first step to helping you stand out from the rest of the crowd. So I went on the interview. The interview went great, and I thought for sure I was going to get the job. The next thing I know, I get another email saying, hey, you made it to the second rounds of the interviews. I'm like, second rounds? I didn't even know there was going to be any second rounds. I thought this was it. And so I went back and I did some more research, and then I found out that not only is this company like a big corporation, but they are interviewing a lot of people. Like, from my research, I think I found out that they were interviewing 120 people, and out of that 120, they were only hiring 20. And so I was like, I have to do something to make myself stand out. And so what did I have to do? I had to think differently. That's step number two. I had to be innovative. One of the things that I did to help myself stand out and be innovative and think differently was I found out through my research that the company that I was applying for is a paper company. Like, they make tissue, paper, all the necessities that people need in their everyday life. I came up with a plan to help me stand out from my competition. My sister at the time was volunteering with this organization, and they had a printer. I didn't have a printer at the time. So my idea was to, first, I had one of my old professors write out a letter of recommendation for me. And I put that in the manila folder, and I was creating a portfolio. And then I had a list of all the projects that I've done when I was in college. And so I had my sister print out all that stuff for me, and I put it all in a portfolio. And for my second interview, I presented that portfolio. Pause. Let me rewind a little bit. I also learned from my research what type of interview questions that this company asked. From my research, I found that they always ask behavior-based questions. And so I studied behavior-based questions. And I also had people like do a mock interview with me, like do a practice interview with me. I was good at answering behavior-based questions, but I figured everyone else who would be there are good at answering behavior-based questions too. So I was thinking of ways to set myself apart. So the portfolio, it had a letter of recommendation. It had a list of all the projects that I've done when I was at the University of Mississippi. And not just a list, it had the actual projects in there. And so when I got into the interview, I gave them the portfolio, and I had a portfolio. And I was like, before we start, do you mind if I present this to you? And they said, yeah, sure. I said, on the first page, you will see a letter of recommendation from one of my professors. Please feel free to read this on your own time. And then I went through all the projects that I did. Like, this is a project I did for this. This was a situation that I went through with one of the other people who were involved, and this how we ended up resolving it, and this was the result from it. They were so impressed that after I got finished presenting my portfolio to them, they didn't ask me any questions. They started selling me on the position. And that's how I was able to make myself stand out. Let's go back over the steps real quick. Step one was to prepare yourself. Do your research. Do not walk into anything and think that you can just wing it and leave it up to chance. Don't just say a prayer and don't go out and do anything about it. You have to do your research. You have to be knowledgeable on the topic that you're trying to pursue. You know, there are thousands and thousands, even millions of people that are probably trying to get the same opportunity that you're trying to get. Researching and preparing yourself will help you stand out tremendously. Step two was to think differently. Like I just said with step one, there are thousands and millions of people who are trying to get the same opportunity as you. Thinking differently and being innovative would set you apart from any and every one of them. Everyone has an associate's degree. Everyone has a bachelor's degree. Thinking differently and being innovative shows people that you do not go by the book. You set your own path. Like, you see ways to make things better and you go out and do it. Everyone else might just follow the status quo to just get stuff done. But no, you get stuff done how you see it best to get done. And there's one last step, and it's called work. And work ties all of this together, because to prepare yourself and to think differently and to be innovative, you have to put in that work. I'm a firm believer that hard work beats out talent any day of the week. Because when you out here working hard, people see your effort and they see that you actually want it. Not that you just relying on your current knowledge or relying on your current skills. They want to see you out here working and getting things done. Yeah, I might not know it right now, but I'm going to figure it out. And that's what will help you stand out. Yeah. Thank you for rocking with me today. It's your boy, Mike Davis Jr. I'm your life coach, I'm your motivator, and your inspirator. Like I said earlier, this is the next to the last episode for this season, man. Thank you for being so loyal. Thank you for rocking with me. I really appreciate you, man. Have a great week. And remember, I love you. Peace. We'll be right back.